Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host, the Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Grant, and today, as you can see, I'm looking at another Star Wars Black Series figure. This time I'm taking a look at a long-awaited Admiral Piett. Absolutely an amazing likeness, to be fair. Absolutely lovely. But let me just go around the box like I normally do. Again, a nice little picture there of the character himself, Admiral Piett. It is an exclusive. I can't remember if it was a Target exclusive. I can't remember. I bought it a while ago, and I managed to get hold of it for a decent price, so I'm happy that I got it. You're getting a bit of burb at the back. I wouldn't say he's ambitious. He was just literally just... I wouldn't say he's ambitious at all. He just called people for being like... Not called people, but he just... went with his gut, and he wasn't ambitious, and then he just got picked by Vader to be an admiral. So he just literally just pointed things out, things that were just wrong and so on as well. So he kind of sees an opportunity not to overshadow someone, but I wouldn't say ambitious at all. There was no real malice in that at all. He just wanted to voice his opinions. But anyway, enough about the box. Let's get to the character. As you see, Admiral Piett is outside the box, and this guy is pretty good. But before I get to the figure, I'm just going to go through his accessories, which I didn't see the point them doing. But he does come with a pistol, which is a very lovely pistol. It would have been nice if he had a holster to put it in. But being an admiral, being an officer, really, he's not really going to be carrying a sidearm wherever he goes. But it would have been nice if they did include that. But anyway, let's get to the figure. Another accessory, it does come with a hat, which is removable. And I recently just bought one of these hats as well. I got a black one for my costume that I'm building, the TIE fighter pilot. And I got almost like a crewman, so basically two costumes in one. So I got the crewman, I got this hat as well. I got it from the Rebel Seamstress, and it is absolutely spot on. And it is a lovely hat, fits really, really well. Expensive, it was 80 quid because it's custom made, but worth every single penny. But this hat, I love it. So let me just go through. So you got a bit, nice bit of posability with the old heads, a bit up and down movement, a bit of side to side, but not much. You're getting a nice arm rotation there and the old shoulders, and you're getting a bit of a swivel on the old elbows. Very good, because you can put the figures behind the back and have some really good sort of poses there. You're getting a bit of a swivel on the old leg, and you're getting a bit of a twist on the old waist, something like that there. You're getting a really nice knee joint, really nice boots, nice and shiny. And these are the boots I'm trying to get myself in my costume, but they are a bit hard to get. But the only problem I got with mine is the foot. I can't get it to go up. I might need to use a bit of hot water just to do that, but I will get that done. I've been using plasticine at the bottom of the feet so I can stand them up not just in my videos, but in my cabinet as well. But let's go through the finish. The face sculpt is absolutely on point. Really is lovely sculpted, lovely painted, absolutely spot on. I do like the command pips as well there. That's lovely done. And the data cylinders, the code cylinders as well. Really nice. And the, mine's got a bit of a scuffing there. Ah, bit of a shame. Didn't spot that. So mine's got a bit of a blemish. And on the inside there, but that's nothing too bad. I can easily get all that all sorted myself quite easily. The belt is really nice. I got this belt myself. I only got that just recently. Very nice. The gloves are really nicely done, and I do like the old German officer sort of flared sort of trousers as well, which is quite nice. And plus, you can see the peg. You can't really sort of see there, but that's fine. I'm not too bothered about that. I think they've done a good thing with the old trousers and that. But the boots and the finish, absolutely lovely. The back there, the detailing is absolutely on point. Really good uniform. They've done a really phenomenal job there. But I still think the outstanding feature is that face sculpt. Absolutely on point. And this is one person I'd like to meet as well. I'd like to get his autograph. But at the moment, with conventions not happening at the moment because of COVID, they'll have to wait. But overall, it is an outstanding figure, a really good character in Star Wars. Well, you see him when Empire Strikes Back, and then he comes to, Sense of power, and then you see him in as well in Return of the Jedi, where he takes control of the Super Star Destroyer. Absolutely brilliant. And yeah, I'm really, really happy with this figure. I mean, they haven't done many of the officers. Well, nice to see if they can do a couple more from A New Hope, especially the Death Star sort of meeting room. That'd be quite nice if they get all those characters done, especially Motti as well. That'd be quite nice. I got Tarkin. But yeah, so I'm happy with that, happy with this figure, happy with everything about him. The only gripe I got at the moment is no holster for the pistol, which I just find that a bit pointless. He doesn't walk around a pistol, but it would be nice if he had a holster. But the hat does fit on really nice as well. Just look at that. Really, really happy with that. So, like I said, I got a bit of a problem with mine standing up. I'm going to have to sort that out. So thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you will be able to give me a like, share, subscribe. That'd be fantastic. The more people who watch my channel, the more likes, share, subscribes I get, my channel will grow. And that's what I really, really want at the moment. I really want to try and get my video content up there at the moment. So I'm just going through a lot of my backlog of figures in the moment. Hopefully at some point I will be running out of figures, so my channel will go to a little bit of obscurity. So I'm going to try and space them out at least about two a week, maybe one a week, one to two a week, and maybe start doing it, maybe a vlog maybe as well. I've been contemplating doing that as well. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. Please give me a like, share, subscribe, like I said earlier on, and I'll see you guys and girls next time.